Only with the deep concentration can yogis gain realization into the intrinsic natures of the mental and physical phenomena, which leads them to the cessation of suffering, dukkha, which leads them to the cessation of the dukkha, cessation of suffering, dukkha. There are many new things to discover every day if yogis have constant and interpretive mindfulness. As the Buddha said, as long as yogis are awake, they should note their consciousness about awakening. Known as awakening. After that, the yogis wants to open their eyes. They should note as wanting, or wishing. And then, when they open the eyes, they should note opening, and so on. I will summarize the chapter on clear comprehension of the Mahasatipatthana Sutta. Dealing with mindfulness of the daily activities for yogis to practice, to make progress in their meditation. The Buddha thought that whatever yogis are doing, they must note it. When yogis bent or stretch out arms and legs, put on, take off clothes, they must be aware of them as they are. Even when yogis go to the restroom to answer the call of nature, they should be aware of all the activities involved. Every day, when yogis eat, they should be aware of every action, every activity involved in the act of eating. When yogis hold the plate or the cup, they must note it as holding. When they touch, touching. When yogis hold the spoon, the cessation or the holding must be observed. When yogis stretch out their arm, they must be aware of the movement of the stretching. When the spoon touches the food, the touching sensation must be observed. Or when yogis dip the spoon into the soup, that dipping movement must be observed. When they scoop soup with the spoon, That movement must be observed. When yogis drink water or anything, they must be aware of all activities involved in the drinking. When yogis chew something, they must know the chewing. When they lick something, they must know the licking. In this way, each and every action involved in the act of eating must be observed as it is. The Buddha thought that every physical process must be thoroughly realized so as to remove ignorance, which is the cause of the fall view. So, when yogi sit, they must be aware of the sitting posture. When they stand, they must be aware of the standing posture. When they lie down, they must be aware of the lying posture. Sayadaw Ji said in Bahamas, one of the Ummas about 90 years of age could walk 24 hours, could sit 24 hours, could lie down 24 hours. By being aware of the object without sleeping, if the yogi is lying down 2 minutes, they may fall asleep. Years back, he passed away at the age of 92. Sarojini think he had been meditating since he was 40 years of age. We think yogis should imitate him and lying down. The abdomen movement is very obvious, very distant. So, when lying down, notice lying, rising, falling, lying, rising, falling, lying, rising, falling. This is a good medicine for insomnia. When yogis wake up, the first thing of which they are conscious must be noted. These are the examples yogis should take for awareness of daily activities. The Buddha taught them to us. The point is to have a continuous and constant mindfulness for the whole day. For the whole day, there is not a mental state, emotional state, or physical process of which yogis should not be mindful as it is. To be able to do this, yogis can have a continuity of mindfulness, which is the cause of deep concentration on which insight knowledge is being up. Once the inside knowledge or the specific characteristics or general characteristics of mental and physical processes has been developed. Yogis go through all 13 stages of inside knowledge, one after another and higher and higher. After yogis have completed all the stages of inside knowledge, they become enlightened. That means yogis attain the first stage of enlightenment. It is called Magga. It is called Magga, the path. When yogis have attained the first stage of enlightenment, they totally uproot the most important defilements, kilesa, sakaya, deity. The false views of a person, a being, an I, or a you, and also doubt about the triple gem. These two mental defilements are uprooted once and for all. Then yogis feel happy. Yogis feel happy and live in peace and happiness. Saroji said, Saroji mentioned, observing a daily activity is very much important. There are some who have gone through about 4 or 5 stages of vipassana insight. There may be someone who has gone through about 7 or 8. There may be some who have gone through 10 or 11. We would like all yogis to complete all stages of inside knowledge. But yogis have some deep concentration occasionally and also some insight which penetrates into reality of the body, mind, processes. When yogi's insight becomes more and more powerful, more and more penetrating, they experience the higher stages of insight knowledge. Sometimes they may be able to attain enlightenment by observing daily activities attentively and precisely. In this case, I should mention some impressive stories, such as the story of the Venerable Ananda and his attainment of the final enlightenment, Arada Magga and Phalajnana. The Venerable Ananda was practicing walking meditation very mindfully at night, observing each movement of the feet very well. Practicing walking meditation very mindfully at night, observing each movement of the feet very well. Then, after walking meditation, he went to his room. That story all yogi know, already know. He went to his room, observing each step in more details. He was mindful of all his actions and movements when he opened the door, when he pulled the door, when he pushed the door, and so on, until he has a sword on his bed. He was mindful of all actions and movements attentively and precisely. When he was sitting down to the bed, he was mindful of the movements of the sitting down and touching sensation of the bed. Before he started his sitting meditation, he wanted to take a rest for a while by lying down on the bed for relaxation. He then started to lie down towards the pillow, being mindful of all movements very attentively, making mental note as lying down, lying down, lying down. Before his head touched the pillow, whine, his two feet were just lifted from the ground, he attained three higher stages of enlightenment consecutively: Sakadagami Magga Jnana, Anagami Magga Jnana, and Arahata Magga Jnana. Thus, he attained arahantship, the final state of enlightenment, before his head touched the pillow. His head touched the pillow. So, the Venerable Ananda attained arahantship not while standing, sitting, walking or lying. His attainment of arahantship was out of all the four postures. What I want to find out is that the Venerable Ananda, the pious attendant of the Buddha, attained arahantship by being aware of all actions and movements in the daily adipati. Daily adipati. That's one another stories. In the same way, the famous Bhikkhuni Bhattacharya, Pime Bhikkhu. Bhikkhuni Bhattacharya also attained arahantship by being aware of daily activities attentively. Daily activities attentively, she was practicing walking meditation very mindfully during the night. She attained deep concentration and clear insight into the movements of the feet, then she wanted to sit in her room. She went to her room by being aware of all actions and movements in the daily activities. When she sat on her bed, she was also aware of the sitting down movements, touching sensation and so on. In the room, there was a wine lamp with a flame. She wanted to extinguish the flame so that she could save the wine and could sit in the dark with a deep concentration. She picked a piece of a bamboo stick and gradually stretches her arm towards the wine lamp. Observing each movement of the stretching, when the hand reached near the flame, she pressed the wick into the wine with the stick, noting each movement of the pressing. At the moment when the wick has sunk into the wine completely and the flame was extinguished, she attained arahatship. She attained arahatship, uprooting all the kilesa, mental defilements. In this way, yogis can attain arahatship if they take awareness of daily activities seriously and strive their best to have a continuity of mindfulness by being constantly aware of each action and movement very well. Attentive and detailed awareness of daily activities is very much important because it can help yogis to attain any stage of enlightenment, which fat and fruition knowledge. Because it can help yogis to attain any stage of enlightenment with fat and fruition knowledge. In the teaching of the Buddha, the practice of vipassana meditation is likened to the rubbing of two pieces of wood or bamboo. In the ancient time, people in the forest had to rub two pieces of bamboo or wood against each other constantly and continuously. Without a break to make fire. Heat is generated on the pieces of a bamboo, after some time, gradually the heat increases and the bamboo becomes hotter and hotter, hotter and hotter. If they start rubbing, the heat becomes cold. If they rub again, they begin to get the heat again. If they start again, the heat becomes cold again. They do not get the fire because they do not continuously rub the pieces. If they rub the pieces or the bamboo continuously and constantly without a break, the heat becomes hot enough. It makes the flame and they get the fire. They get the fire. Very good example. That is why meditation teachers say yogis should be constantly and continuously mindful of whatever is arising in their body and mind as they really are. Mindfulness must be constant and continuous so that it becomes shabba and more powerful. Shabba and more powerful. Then it makes a concentration deeper. When the concentration becomes deeper, there arises the insight which penetrates. Which penetrates into the true nature of mental and physical phenomena, nama and rupa. If yogis are mindful of arising mental and physical processes for about 15 or 20 minutes, they then take rest for about 5 minutes without being mindful of the physical and mental phenomena occurring at the present moment. Then again, they pick up their effort, vidya, and are aware of some movements which arise. In this way, they practice meditation on and out, off. In this way, they practice meditation on and off. As a result, they are not able to have continuous and constant mindfulness. Their concentration, therefore, cannot be deep enough. Because of this, they will not gain the inside knowledge that realizes the true nature of mental and physical phenomena. Mental and physical phenomena. They cannot remove the wrong view of a person, being a self or a soul, Sakaya deity and Atta deity. If yogis rightly understand the value of a continuous mindfulness and deep concentration, they will observe all actions and movements in sitting, walking, and daily activities. Then their mindfulness becomes continuous and constant. Their concentration becomes deeper and deeper. They are like people who rub the two pieces of wood constantly and continuously without a break. Eventually, the insights arise. They realize the true nature of mental and physical phenomena, and they are hopeful to attain the cessation of suffering and nibbana. So, the awareness of the daily activities is so much important that the Buddha taught us Sambhajanapapa, the chapter on clear comprehension, in Mahasatipatthana Sutta, to rightly understand the value of the daily activities. Yogis should strive to have a continuous and constant mindfulness by being mindful of all activities for the whole day. Realize all mental and physical phenomena and attain the cessation of suffering, nibbana. During a retreat, all yogis have to do is to be mindful. They need not hurry. The most venerable Mahasi Seoroji compare a yogi to a sick person who moves about very slowly, and very mindfully. Doing this slowly makes the mind concentrated. If yogi is intent to achieve something in their meditation, they must get accustomed to slowing down. Next one, when a fan is turning fast, we cannot see it. As it really is. If it is turning slowly, then we can see each individual blade. So yogis have to slow down to be able to see clearly the mental and physical processes as they really are. When being surrounded by people who are doing things in a rush, yogis must ignore the surroundings and energetically note any mental or physical activity. Also, talking is a great danger to the progress of insight. A five-minute talk can damage a yogi's concentration for the whole day. Sayaroji said, a yogi do not read do not recite or recollect they are hindrances to meditation progress. Nays Sambhajana Baba original policy. Original Pali's Punachapram Bakerway Baku Bakandi Brakandi Sambhajana Kari Hoti Alogi De Wilogi De Sambhajana Kari Hoti Samenji De Basari De Sambhajana Kari Hoti Sangadi Bada Chivara Dharani Sambhajana Kari Hoti Asite Pite Kha Pite Khaite Saite Sambhajana Kari Hoti Ochara Basawa Kame Sambhajana Kari Hoti Gade Tite Nisene Sode Jagariye Vasite Doni Bhavi Doni Bhavi and so onward. Translations and again Bhikkhus a Bhikkhu in going forward and in going back applies clear comprehension in looking straight on and in looking away from the front. He applies a clear comprehension in bending his limbs and in stretching his limbs. He also applies clear comprehension in wearing the double robe and other robes, and in carrying the bow, he applies a clear comprehension. In eating, drinking, chewing, and swearing, he applies a clear comprehension. Clear comprehension. In walking, standing, sitting, falling asleep, waking, speaking, keeping silent, he applies a clear comprehension. Thus, he dwells contemplating on the body, and the body internally, externally. He dwells contemplating on the body and the body internally. He dwells contemplating on the body and the body in the body externally. He dwells contemplating on the body and the body both externally, internally, and externally. Thus, two bhikkhus. A bhikkhu dwells contemplating the body in the body. Okay, that's all for today. May you all be able to practice meditation well and quickly attain that Nibbana which the Buddhas, Arahants, and Ariyas have experienced. Sadhu, sadhu, sadhu.